What was sick shall be healed. What was not there shall be there. Where there was no answer, there shall be an answer. Where there was no direction, there shall be a direction in the next 10 days. This I seal by the blood of Jesus. It is well with you. I cover it by the blood of Jesus. No devil will steal it. No devil will block it. No devil will stand in the way of it. It shall surely come to pass. Thank you, Lord. That's what the Lord told me. I need those testimonies. I need those testimonies. Who is so strong in my life? So strong. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Lord. I see light. If you are under darkness, I see light. Something ebesufuna ukgive up akiyo, Jehovah will surprise you in the next 10 days.
But let me tell you something. They introduce an object into your life because this is you sleeping and you dreaming and you eating in the dream. I saw something like a moving object in your tummy. You will have some serious problems with your this part. Because you were sleeping and you dreamt, and this is more like meat that you were eating in the dream. That's when they introduced this whole thing into you. And then your health started to fail you. Started to fail you. Let me tell you something. They will tell you about kidneys. Kidneys. And then they were going to subject you to what's this thing that they call? Because dialysis. That's where they were taking you to now. Because your body was just like swelling. That's what was going to happen. But the Spirit of the Lord said, you have done well by coming here.
Amen.
Because what I saw was like, who told you about
Mom Timon.
What I saw was a countdown on your life. You are going to lose this husband. A serious countdown. But the arrow shall go back to the same. What business did you do before?
We sold juice. And then we had an automatic...
Because what I see is not the first business. Why?
No, it's not.
It's not the first
business. Yes,
you see, there is one thing that we must understand as black people. There are things that we won't take. Namos ambulal mutangegi zegit. This man from an early age, like I see you at school, like you selling, stuff, sweets. You're selling sweets at school. What did you sell at school?
That's
my father. Can I prophesy? This is something, he's not just starting this thing, it's not by chance that he's doing what. From an early age, this anointing for business was upon his life. At school, selling sweets. Did I go to school with you?
No. First time I see you.
Lord will give you a sign, and by this sign you will know that you have met the man of God. Somebody will carry your sickness.
Jesus. Yes, brother.
There is a spirit of delay. I told you, your friend, there is a spirit of delay here about to cancer, but it is coupled with the spirit of promise and faith. You know, like they promise you, and when they have to deliver, people are going to deliver. So I heard that waiting for somebody has to do with that job they pitch.
Yeah. We're still waiting for answers.
You're still waiting for answers. Listen. What is going to delay the answer for is your ear. So when you talk to me, you don't know that. Yeah. So you still waiting?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Jesus. saw, because we have said it is in the spirit. Whosoever must come and bring your answer, this week is coming. You go to work. Don't forget the house of the Lord. You come in, we'll give you talent. Then you see the Lord is going to take you even to greater heights. Because what I see happening here, it is the plan of the enemy, but I scatter it against your life.
Amen.
I scatter the plan of the enemy against your life. It is the plan of the enemy to see you going further down and making you miss out. So I terminate it and I end it. You won't get your job this week. And then you come back and testify to the glory of the Lord.
You were told, because what I see on your feet, I see like beads around your feet. Do you know what beads are? I see red color, I see like a white color, and these are beads of Isangoma. You hear me? These are beads of Isangoma. Why? Because I saw like a graveyard spirit running from your mother's side, not your father's side, your mother's side. Because I see like a woman, white complexion, just like you, who went to this thing, okay, twice. But yes, who is that? It's your aunt. Can I what I see in the spirit realm, your aunt did not finish. She didn't finish. Did she finish?
No.
She didn't. What happened? You see now, this is like somebody who went there, and now the process had to be like finish. But something happened, and now she had to come home. But now she's coming home with these things. But can I tell you something? As much as your aunt went there to do this Sangoma training, your aunt could not see. She could not see. She was a blind Sangoma. She never helped anybody anywhere. Just a waste of time. Now I saw that spirit coming after you now, because this is you sleeping. And you see like dead people. Why are these like relatives dead? You see them in the dream. Who do you see in the dream? What is she doing? Is your grandmother still alive?
No.
She's dead. You see now, I saw this graveyard spirit being summoned from the grave. And the spirit of the Lord is directing my attention to her feet. Because while I'm looking on her feet, these are like beats. And as a result, you can't live with a man.
Professor!
I'm divorced.
That's my father! The son of General! Can't live with a man. Unnecessary fights that are leading to this. But you see what I saw? Somebody from your ex-husband family stirring up all these things. Stirring up trouble. Because what I saw when somebody didn't like you from your in-laws. You know what I'm talking about? Because I see you receiving a call, and this person telling you straight to your face, we will see if you will last. Who is that? Professor! Mama, did they not tell you? Who was that? What did she tell you? They tied your wound. They told you straight in your eyes. Because I see you like coming out and the man is chasing you out like a dog. But there is a God in heaven. Yes! Thank God you are still beautiful. Even though you came out of that. Can I connect you to a hunk? See, look at your life. You came out of that man's house with nothing. 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 And you are there. The God who can take nothing and make something is. All right.
Most probably Popo. Still fine. makes you no longer like a prophet of God. As you enter heaven, it starts with you. I see you sitting in the office. This is a letter from the head office. Are you here, Pastor?
Yes.
Most of you will get trouble next time. No letter from the head office.
Yes, I receive.
You are due for something in terms of a position there.
Thank you.
Because you've been doing this for so long now.
It's been 10 years.
10 years?
Yes.
Sitting in one place?
Yes.
I pray that in the name of Jesus. You will get a letter. They will call you number one. You will pass it to your husband. We are getting away. Then they will come with your husband.
Thank you.
Because, I don't know, I see driving at work. Driving.
Yes.
What is driving?
He's driving a motorbike.
He's driving a motorbike.
Yes.
They will make him a hate of the drivers. You believe in him?
Yes, I do.
You spoke to me before?
Yes.
Well.
They will tell you, you shall die. Give me your offense.